Maybe everybody's. Maybe not everybody is watching the debate tonight. Cannot believe we still take that stuff serious, but if a couple of you guys get on, I'll continue. If not, then I'll just make a YouTube video on my channel, the Backyard Gospel Project, about how much NASA lies. I've done had enough of the lies and not talking about it. So a couple of you guys jump on, we'll get to it. If this was a YouTube video, I wouldn't really care too much. But in order for people to get it, I want to get it live so people will see it. Looking at several articles about NASA. My wife sent me a picture, I think it was yesterday, a screenshot of little televisions at the gas stations about NASA. So that just really started digging under my skin about all this stuff with them. Hey Leah, good to see you. Talking about NASA, how much they lie. I can't take no more. Number one, why would the world system lie? Psalm 19:1, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament sheweth his handiwork. That's why. To take the glory of God away from him, or to attempt to. Okay? That's the number one question I get is, why would they lie? Why would they tell the truth? Have you ever thought about that? Why would men tell the truth? So, my wife sent me a picture the other day, screenshot, you know, you can't even pump gas anymore without having to watch television right there in front of your face. So she sent me a screenshot of what they were showing her. NASA and Nokia to install 4G on the lunar surface. Of course, they always do a long-term plan. They reveal these things. Well, MOVE is part of U.S. Space Agency's plan to establish a long-term human presence on the moon by 2030. Even though we went 1960s, late 60s, early 70s, several times, they're projecting to be 2030. No one has been back, and they're projecting it to be that far from now. 10 years from now. 9 years almost. Whatever, you know what I mean. Oh, man. First, I didn't even know Nokia still existed. So, why not 5G? Why stop at 4G? Make a longer plan, you know, 2040. Put 5G on the moon. You never know. So NASA and Nokia to install 4G on lunar surface. Ridiculous. All right, how about this? This is from 2 days ago. I would show you guys, and I'll try to. I don't know if you see it very well, but. All right, so. Touchdown declared, an asteroid NASA probe attempts to collect samples for Earth to return. Here we go. Awesome. Yeah, right.
History could be made today on the other side of the solar system. This afternoon, a NASA spacecraft will make a daring attempt to collect a sample from an asteroid and then bring it back to Earth. If successful, this would be the space agency's largest
good
return
CGI right
to
there.
Terrestrial material since the Apollo program brought back rocks and dust from the moon. The asteroid named Bennu is...
All right. You guys feel free to comment. Asteroid named Bennu. So I said, okay, what does Bennu mean? It's not that hard, okay? Just, we've got to look this stuff up. Satan has all these little gadgets and gizmos. Why do you think our phones are called devices? Because it distracts us. like this. We walk around like this. Yeah. Binu. I just typed in, what does Binu mean? It is an ancient Egyptian deity linked to the sun, creation, and rebirth. He may have been the original inspiration for the phoenix legends that developed in Greek mythology. I mean, this is a joke. Whew. So that's what Binu means, this asteroid, allegedly, that NASA landed a probe on. Why do you think they call it a probe? Come on. 4.5 billion year old asteroid. So they're sending the probe to the asteroid to take a sample to bring back to be studied, but they already know how old it is. All right. NASA's lies are deeply rooted. Here is first moon phone call, BBC America. This is Richard Nixon back in, I think, 1969, calling the moon, the men allegedly on the moon, 240,000 miles away, allegedly, on a landline. You want to watch this?
Neil and Buzz, the President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you, over. That would be an honor. Go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston now.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House. And this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made. I just can't tell you how proud we all are of what you... For every American, this has to be the proudest day of our lives. And for people all over the world, I am sure they too join with us in recognizing what an immense feat this is. Because of what you have done, the heavens have become a part of man's world. And as you talk to us from the sea of...
Now, I don't know if the clip they just showed was after they landed after they came back from the moon, allegedly, because I saw Nixon's mouth was not moving the same as the words. But if that's not true, if this was still before they came back from the moon, allegedly, this picture was supposedly from the moon. Taken from the moon back to Earth. First off, Earth is allegedly 4 times bigger than the moon. So it wouldn't even look like that. Number two, how did he get a picture up before they even got back? And this shot right here, I know it's hard to see because I got my light on back behind me. All you do is you go to YouTube and you type in "a funny thing happened on the way to the moon." I wasn't able to download that video, but it will show you this screenshot, this part of the video right here. The astronauts in Apollo 11 testified on the audio of that shot. They were halfway to the moon. Okay. Well, it shows that this shot was faked. It shows it on the documentary. Okay. So this shot is a fake shot of Earth, allegedly halfway to the moon.
Interest and a curiosity and
And this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made.
All right, give me just a second. I got to back it up a little bit. He talks about the heavens in a second.
They too join with the in recognizing what an immense feat this is.
It's all about being collective. The heavens have become a part of man's world. You start with Genesis. Did God give man dominion over the heavens? Over, now that's heavens plural he just used. You got to pay attention to what people say. Words matter. Did he give dominion to man over the heavens or earth? Which one? The attempt of man to reach to the heavens was at the Tower of Babel. They are one speech, one mind, this and that. They build a city and a tower to reach to the heavens. Okay? It's not a good thing. God saw what they were doing. He came down. He confounded their languages, spread them abroad. You know? Why do you think English is soon to be the most prevalent language known to mankind? Because they're coming together again. They're doing it again. The heavens have become part of man's world, is what he said. It's back in 1969, guys. All right, so I got a few pictures here. I just don't care. Which one of these is a real picture of Earth? Which one? Huh? Alright, you see, let's see, this one right here, see all them lines? It's got lines all through it. That's called a composite. That's not a real picture. Alright, see how big Africa is right here? Man, I hope you guys can see that. Got small, let's see, that's not what I want to show you. Okay, America. See how big America is right there? See, that's Mexico. Then you come over here is Florida, in that little corner. I know you can't see it very good. Look how small it is on the other ones. See up here? Same size sphere, but the continents are different sizes. You got the lines going through it. That's called a composite. That's a computer-generated image. All right, let's look at God's word and see what it says about the heavens, about earth. Let's talk about the firmament. You can believe whatever you want to. You put your faith in whatever you want to. Okay, when you put your faith in something, if when you believe something, that's called putting your faith in what they're telling you is true. Brother Paul Lucas put it so perfectly in one of his sermons about this stuff. He said, you're putting your faith in someone else's profession of knowledge. Why do you think when you go to university they call them professors? They're professing themselves to be wise. But what does the Bible say? They became fools. Talking about the Gentiles, Old Testament. Well, this is the time of the Gentiles. Time of the Gentiles. Same exact system. Alright. God said, let there be a firmament in the midst of the waters. Let it divide waters from waters. That's not air, okay? God made the firmament, divided the waters which are under the firmament, and the waters above the firmament. It was so. There's waters above what we look at every night. There's waters above our heads. You say, that sounds ridiculous. I know it does. You put your faith in man, it sounds ridiculous. Faith in the Lord, I'm telling you. Psalm 148. Praise ye the Lord. Praise ye the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights. That's up. Praise ye him, all his angels. Praise ye him, all his hosts. Praise ye him, sun and moon. Praise him, all ye stars of light. my son's going through second grade. They're like, hey, stars are made out of plasma. You don't know that. Lightning is made out of plasma. Lightning is made out of electricity. It's that simple. So what are stars made out of? Light. See, it's too hard for man to comprehend because of his pride. Praise him, ye heavens of heavens, and ye waters that be above the heavens. When you zoom into a star, I got a P900 camera. I need to start uploading my star videos. When you zoom into a star and you hold it steady, it shimmers like it's in water. So that's the atmosphere. How you know? You don't know. Well, you don't know nothing compared to God Almighty. You know nothing. Then I look, okay. Revelation 4:6, before the throne there was a sea of glass. It doesn't say, okay. Before the throne of God, above our heads, up there, before the throne of God, there was a sea of glass like unto crystal. He didn't say it's like a sea of glass, kind of, you know. It could be metaphorically whatever you want it to be. He says it was a sea of glass like unto crystal. It's like crystal. He's not saying it's crystal. It's like crystal. But he said it's a sea of glass. Hast thou with him spread out the sky, which is strong, and as a molten looking glass. He doesn't say, he's not saying it's a molten looking glass. He's saying it's like a molten looking glass, but it is strong. Strong. Spread out the sky. Okay? How about in the flood, Genesis 7, it says the fountains of the great deep are broken up, the windows of heaven, okay, and, so the fountains of the great deep and the windows of heaven were opened, and it rained. That's three different sources of water. Let's talk about the earth, 2 Peter 3:5, for this they willingly are ignorant of, that by the word of God the heavens were of old. And the earth standing out of the water and in the water. What was that verse the other day that I saw? Man, it was awesome. It was in the Psalms. That the earth, he spread out the earth above the waters. What was that verse? I gotta look that up real quick. It was awesome, man. Awesome. And it pretty much mimics Genesis 1. Let me find it real quick. Alright, Psalm 136, 5 through 9. To him that by wisdom made the heavens. Who has wisdom? God has wisdom. Grace and peace, Lisa. We're talking about NASA, how they lie, and how God is true. Every man's a liar. To him that by wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that stretched out the earth above the waters. Does that sound like the heliocentric sphere model? No. For his mercy endureth forever. To him that made great lights, for his mercy endureth forever. The sun to rule by day, for his mercy endureth forever. The moon and stars to rule by night, his mercy endureth forever. Psalm 136, 5 through 9. It's amazing. Okay, how about the apostle, our apostle? 2 Corinthians 12:2. I knew a man in Christ above 14 years ago, whether in the body I cannot tell, or out of the body I cannot tell. God knoweth. Such a one is caught up to the third heaven. Caught up to the third heaven. God called the firmament heaven. So the firmament is one of the heavens. And the evening, morning, second day. That's Genesis 1:8. Ezekiel 1:22, the likeness of the firmament above the heads of the living creature was the color of a terrible crystal stretched forth over their heads above. Under the firmament were wings straight, so on and so forth. Let's see. Okay. And above the firmament that was over their heads was the likeness of a throne, and as the appearance of the sapphire stone. and upon the likeness of the throne was the likeness and appearance of a man above upon it. Who is that? Who is sitting on that throne up there? Who's that? That's Jesus Christ. You know, let God be true and every man a liar. When we read the scriptures, when it's concerning the earth, the heavens, the sun, the moon, the stars, if it wasn't important, it wouldn't be in His Word. Revelation 6:14, the heaven departed as a scroll. People, man, they ripped that joker apart right there. It means what it says it means. When it is rolled together, every mountain and island were moved out of their places. Behold, He cometh with clouds. This is Revelation 1:7. Every isle shall see Him. This is the second coming of Christ. And they also which pierced Him, all kings of the earth shall wail because of Him. Even so, amen. You better believe it, man. Even so, amen. If you want to see about one speech and one accord, go to Genesis 11, Matthew 4:8. So Genesis 11 talks about the Tower of Babel. That's what I'm talking about with this stuff going on with NASA. NASA going to put 4G on the moon. Okay, this whole thing, this was 2 days ago. I'm recapping for you guys. Appreciate you guys joining me. NASA probe attempts to collect samples for return to Earth on this asteroid. 4.5 billion years old. How do they know that? They haven't even studied it yet, right? The asteroid name is Bennu. Bennu is an ancient Egyptian deity linked with the sun, creation, and rebirth. He may have been the original inspiration for the Phoenix legends that developed the Greek mythology. It's a joke, guys. It's smoke and mirrors. You're going up, they're declaring they're going to the heavens where man has no dominion. No dominion was ever given to man in the heavens. So they got to come up with it because they can't get up there. They got to come up with stuff to make you think they're high and mighty, higher than God Almighty, and they're not. All right? The time that when man has done it, had tried to attempt to go up to the heavens in Genesis 11, God said, no, you're not, and ripped it down. You can't go to heaven without the righteousness of Jesus Christ given to your account by trusting the gospel of grace. You cannot be with Him without Him. You can't go where He is without Him. And the rulers of this world know that, and they hate it. They're prideful, just like their father, the devil. They hate it. They can't stand Jesus Christ. Psalm 2. Why do the heathen rage, and the people imagine a vain thing? The rulers of the world set themselves against the Lord, against His anointed, saying, let us break His bands asunder, and cast our cords, this and that. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh. He's laughing at NASA. Are you kidding me? This stuff's a joke. Bennu? What? I don't know if it's a probe or what. It's hilarious they call it a probe. It's called Osiris Rex. Rex is king in, I believe, Latin. Osiris was an ancient false god. Let's look it up real quick. This stuff is not a joke. You live in an evil world. Our conversation is in heaven. We look for the Savior. Trump's not your Savior. You know, you watch a daggone debate and stuff, Trump's not your Savior. If He is, man, you don't know the love of Christ, man. Osiris. How do they... okay, let me read it for you. Tristan, thanks for joining us, man. Genesis 11:9. The whole earth was of one language, one speech, so they can communicate with each other. Came to pass as they journeyed from the east, they found a plain in the land of Shinar, and they dwelt there, and they said to one another, go to, let us make brick and burn them thoroughly. and they had brick for stone and slime they made for mortar. They said, go to, let us build a city and a tower whose top may reach unto heaven, and let us make us a name, lest we be scattered abroad upon the face of the whole earth. So collectivism, let's just get collective. University, that's not diversity, it's a university. And the Lord came down, he came down. The simplicity of the scripture is up, down, east, west. That's the simplicity of God's word. Up, down. If you're on the side of a ball, is up, up, or is down, up? How does that work? Who's top? Okay. Lord came down to see the city and the tower which the children of men builded. And the Lord said, behold, the people is one. They have all one language. And this they begin to do. And now nothing will be restrained from them. The imaginations of men is evil without God's knowledge in their minds. Which they have, imagine to do. Go to, let us go down, and there confound their language, that they may not understand one another's speech. So the Lord scattered them abroad from thence upon the face of all the earth, and they left off to build the city. They left off. They left it. He didn't destroy the city. They left from doing it. Well, I tell you, the world today is coming back in the collectivism, right? Therefore is the name of it called Babel, or Babel, however you want to say it. There's a language software today that you hear it on the Pandora commercials on Pandora Radio. It's called Babel. They're spitting right in your face. Because the Lord did there confound the language of all the earth, and from thence did the Lord scatter them abroad upon the face of all the earth. Okay. So Matthew 4:8, again the devil takes Jesus up into a exceeding high mountain and sheweth him all the kingdoms of the world and the glory of them. People say, well, this is just that's just, you spiritualize that, you know. The devil went into another dimension, he showed Jesus all the different spiritual kingdoms that he has dominion over and all this stuff. And what's the point of taking him to an exceeding high mountain to show him the kingdoms if it's just going to be something spiritual? It doesn't say spiritual. Let's see. What language did God speak, or what? In scripture, the Lord speaks Hebrew. Mostly Hebrew to the Hebrew people. Old Testament was written in Hebrew. The New Testament was written in Greek. Maybe I think a part of Daniel, a little sliver of Daniel, was written in Aramaic. I know when the Lord spoke to Saul of Tarsus in Acts chapter 9, and then you go to Acts, I think 26, he spoke in a Hebrew tongue. The modern versions say Aramaic, but it's Hebrew tongue. So the devil takes the Lord to an exceeding high mountain, shows him the kingdoms of the world. Where's the curvature? It's that simple. It's the simplicity of God's word. All right. Let's see. The moon has its own light. Mark 13:24. But in those days after that tribulation, it's talking about the time of Jacob's trouble in the future, the sun shall be darkened, and the moon shall not give her light. In scripture, the moon is a her and the sun is a he. Okay? Revelation 21:23. And the city had no need of the sun, neither of the moon, to shine in it. For the glory of God did lighten it, and the Lamb is the light thereof. Jesus Christ. 1 Corinthians 15:41, this talks about, now he's talking about in context the resurrection. But he kind of hints towards sun, moon, and stars here There's one glory of the sun, another glory of the moon, another glory of the stars, for one star differeth from another star in glory. Hey, Tristan, appreciate it, man. Join us next time, brother. Have a good night, man, and I pray that you trust Christ as your Savior, man. Gospel of grace. He died for all of our sins, your sins. He buried and rose again. Just trust and believe that alone. And the Lord says he is counted to you as righteousness. Jeremiah 31:35. Oh, let's see. Hold on a second. Nope. Ezekiel 32:7. When I shall put thee out, I will cover the heaven and make the stars thereof dark. I will cover the sun with a cloud, and the moon shall not give her light. Thus saith the Lord, this is Jeremiah 31:35, which giveth the sun for a light by day, and the ordinances of the moon and of the stars for a light by night, which divideth the sea when the waves thereof roar. The Lord of hosts is his name. Isaiah 13:10, for the stars of heaven and the constellations thereof shall not give their light. The sun shall be darkened in his going forth, and the moon shall not cause her light to shine. All right? The moon does not reflect the sun's light. They tell you these things, and I believe all this stuff, guys. They tell you these things in school because they can explain God's creation. Psalm 19, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament sheweth his handiwork. That's why the world system lies. Okay? Not the teachers, this and that and the other. They're doing what they're told. Where the origin, the root, is where this stuff comes from. The earth cannot be measured. Alright? And is finished. Genesis 2. This is after the account of creation. Thus the heavens, plural, so three heavens, and the earth were finished, and all the host of them. We're told we live in an ever-expanding universe. Of course, they change that every couple years, but God said Genesis 2, he was done. He created what he wanted created. Have a little side thought about that. I had this thought earlier today. Why did he create anything? He's God. He doesn't need anything. Why did he create anything? Especially, why did he create mankind? I believe it's because of his mercy, his love, his grace, you know, to share his glory with mankind and to see what we've done to it and to see what he had to do to redeem us by the cross. See, the cross, the gospel of grace, is a lot of negative stuff. You know, it shows God's grace, his righteousness, his wrath upon sin, his mercy, forgiveness. His attributes are right there, man. Both sides of God were displayed at the cross, by the cross. You know. So, Apostle Paul talks about this stuff in Romans 1 about, let's go to Romans 1. Man, the Bible teaches something, guys. It ain't this religious stuff, going to church and just hanging out, man. You know? It ain't about hanging out, eating some good food, and going right back home. Man, this is God's words, man. This is the creator of heaven and earth. You know what? I mean, come on. Do you believe there's a creator? If you do, he wrote down words for us to read, and it's in a King James Bible for us English-speaking people. It's an amazing thing whenever you dig in this word. If you're saved, he's your heavenly father. Do you hold things back from your kids? Like, hey, Daddy, what is 2 plus 2? Don't worry about it, son. Get out of here. No, you don't do that. right after he says this, right after the Apostle Paul, the apostle to the body of Christ, verse 15 of chapter 1, "So as much as in me is, I am ready to preach the gospel to you that are in Rome also, for I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, Jew first, also to the Greek." Alright. Let's see. Verse 20, "For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen." That's part of Psalm 19. "Being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse." Because that, when they knew God, they glorified him not as God. Talking about the Old Testament Gentiles, before the nation of Israel was formed. "Neither were thankful, became vain in their imaginations." NASA is vain imaginations. You call the moon from a landline. Are you kidding me, guys? Come on. How about SpaceX, Elon Musk? How about the daggum car in space? Y'all want to see that? Have y'all seen that yet? Most people don't even know what they even believe about this NASA stuff in the world system we're taught in school. Let's see. Let's look it up. It says live now, but when you look in the comments, it's not actually live anymore. All right, tell me if you believe this is real. Okay. There's Elon Musk, a little Tesla Roadster. He's got a Starman, is what they call that little fake astronaut, little dummy or whatever. There's supposedly the Earth behind him. All right. I'll keep it playing. I'll let it loop back around and show you. Okay, here's a good shot. Here's a side view. That's awesome. Right? Yeah. You see the reflection of the alleged Earth right there? In a minute, I'll show you that there's no continents on this thing. I mean, it's not, it would be so easy. This is a movie set, guys. Come on. So, Romans 1 talks about creation, shows us God is real. All right, go to Acts 17, and I'll show you about preaching to where most of our cosmology, most of our the mythology, a lot of our teachings come from Greeks. A lot of it is Roman influence. A lot of this stuff can be looked up very easily. Though this has actually got a continent on that. I'll show it to you. All right, so there you go. What's hilarious is they said that it orbits the Earth, but all it's doing is just doing this circle and then going in a little circle, and the globe never changes shape, size, or whatever. We've got to open our minds, open our eyes, open our ears to these things, and stop being deceived. King David says, "I hate and abhor lying." You know, I hate being lied to. God ain't gonna lie to you, man. Lord is not a man that he should lie, neither a son of man that he should repent. Acts 17, Apostle Paul, "Now when they had passed through..." Let's see, I gotta read more than that. I gotta read further than that because that's a lot to read. Okay. Let's see. Devout Greeks. Okay. Now when this is Acts 17:16. "Now while Paul waited for them at Athens, his spirit was stirred in him when he saw the city wholly given to idolatry." The city of Athens, all right, in Greece. "Therefore disputed he with the synagogue with the Jews and the devout persons in the market daily with them and met with him. Then certain philosophers," the scripture uses philosophers, I believe, only two times, one in Colossians and one right here, and philosophy is not a good thing, okay? The wisdom of God tells you philosophy is not a good thing. the philosophers of the Epicureans and of the Stoics encountered him and said, some said, what will this babbler say? Now, wait a minute now. The Apostle Paul was chosen by the Lord Jesus Christ to be the first member of the body of Christ and to preach the gospel of grace. And these Athenians are so ignorant of God, they call Paul a babbler. The next part of that verse. Other some, he seemeth to be a setter forth of strange gods, because he preached to them Jesus and the resurrection. Okay? That's why they called him a babbler. They took him and brought him unto Areopagus, saying, may we know what this new doctrine whereof thou speakest is. So the Athenians were so ignorant of God, okay, they sat there and what new doctrine is this? What is this Jesus, you know, you babbler? Now, these were men that wanted to hear all sorts of different things. We'll read that here in a second. Areopagus, may we know what this new doctrine whereof thou speakest is? For thou bringest certain strange things to our ears. We would know, therefore, what these things mean. For all the Athenians and the strangers which were there spent their time in nothing else but either to tell or to hear some new thing. So these men were used to hearing different ideologies, different things, debating. Romans 1 talks about debate. It's not good. Then Paul stood in the midst of Mars Hill. If you have a modern version, it just translates it as the same as the verse 19, Areopagus. Well, God's word says Mars Hill. Why does it say that for? God wants you to know Mars Hill is pretty much in Athens, the court of morals. I got some notes I wrote down here. Mars is the Greek god of war. The worship place of Mars, a place to examine Paul. I got a question mark there. To examine him is pretty much to size him up. Mars Hill. They have Paul before where they, I don't know, just pure speculation, appeal to the god of war, Mars. Okay? We have a planet named Mars. Okay? 2 Kings 23:5 talks about planets. Men worship them. Right? And said, ye men of Athens, I perceive that in all things ye are too superstitious. Modern versions say religious. They weren't religious, they were superstitious. For as I passed by and beheld your devotions, I found an altar with this inscription, to the unknown God. Okay, they're ignorant of God and his righteousness. Whom therefore ye ignorantly worship, him declare I unto you. Paul's going to declare God to the Athenians. God that made the world and all things therein. Read John 1, Colossians 1. Jesus Christ, by him were made all things. For him and by him. Alright? Seeing that he is Lord of heaven and earth. Jesus Christ is Lord of all. Alright? Dwelleth not in temples made with hands. He don't live in church buildings. Neither is worshipped with men's hands, as though he needed anything. Seeing he giveth to all life, breath, and all things, and hath made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on all the face of the earth, hath determined the times therefore appointed and the bounds of their habitation, that they should seek the Lord. We were talking about this today, earlier. You know, not everybody believes what you believe. I don't care what you think I believe. I want you to search for yourself the truth. If you're not searching for truth, you're definitely 100% not going to find it. Okay? That they should seek the Lord, if haply they might feel after him and find him, though he be not far from every one of us. Man. Oh, man. Verse 30, in the times of this ignorance, talking about the ignorance spoken about in this chapter, ignorance of God according to creation and according to his righteousness. All right? Times of this ignorance God winked at, but now commandeth all men everywhere to repent. What does repent mean? Change your mind of your vain imaginations of who you believe God is and seek him. And I'll tell you, is that my dog? Seek him in the King James Bible. Look outside. I mean, I'm telling you, I believe this world is getting so bad that if the stars were darkened right now, most people wouldn't even notice it. We're so preoccupied with everything in this world. The heavens declare the glory of God. Heavens declare the glory of God. Because he hath appointed a day in the which he will judge the world in righteousness by that man whom he hath ordained, whereof he hath given assurance to all men, and that he hath raised him from the dead, Jesus Christ. When they heard of the resurrection of the dead, some mocked, and others said, we will hear thee again of this matter. So Paul departed from them, among them. Howbeit certain men clave unto him and believed. Man, that's the whole key. Among the which was, of course, he has a few names here. So we got a lot of information tonight, and I know I ramble sometimes. The earth cannot be measured. Job 38:4. Where wast thou when I laid the foundations of the earth? Declare if thou hast understanding. Who hath laid the measures thereof, if thou knowest? And who hath stretched the line upon it? Whereupon are the foundations thereof fastened, or who laid the cornerstone thereof? When the morning stars, which is the angels, sang together, and all the sons of God shouted for joy. Who shut up the sea with doors when it brake forth, as if it had issued from the womb? When I made the cloud of garment thereof, and the thick darkness a swaddling band for it, and break up for it my decree place, and set the bars and doors. Hast thou commanded the morning since thy days, and caused the dayspring to know its place, that it might take hold of the ends of the earth, that the wicked might be shaken out of it? It is turned as clay to a seal. You got a clay or wax type of seal that they use on, let's say, scrolls, this, that, and the other. The kings used to use it, and we still do today. Royalty, this and that. They take a ring and they smash it, and it folds the edges up. God's describing the earth. Okay? They stand as a garment. Man, I'm telling you, can't get that from NASA. They're not going to tell you that stuff. Let's look and see what line, what God means about the line. Let's compare scripture for scripture. Isaiah 44:13. The carpenter stretcheth out his rule. He marketh it out with a line. He fitteth it with planes, and he marketh it out with a compass. What's a compass as far as in carpentry? You know, a little thing sits there, and you draw a circle with it. He had compassed the waters with bounds, is what he says. To compass something as far as not the instrument itself, but the action of compassing is to surround, all right, and make it after the figure of a man, according to the beauty of a man, and it may remain in his house. So what's the whole point of all this stuff? Oh, Timothy, this is 1 Timothy 6:20. Keep that which is committed to thy trust, avoiding profane and vain babblings, oppositions of science, falsely so called. Let's see. All right, so this is an amazing thing right here in Jeremiah 31:7. It's Thus saith the Lord, if heaven above can be measured, he says if, that's a big if, man, and the foundations of the earth searched out beneath, I will also cast off all the seed of Israel for all that they have done, saith the Lord. That's a bold statement from God Almighty. Only He can declare that type of condition or that type of... It's a declaration is what it is. It's a promise. If it can be searched out, if it can be measured, I'll cast away my people. He said, and he says in another section of Scripture, he will never cast away his people. Whew, man, cast them away. See ya. Bye. Proverbs 25:3, the heaven for height, the earth for depth, and the heart of kings is unsearchable. Believe God's word or you believe man's word? Man says, I mean, do you know the circumference of the earth is what we were taught in school? I didn't know until I started looking into this stuff, guys. They say the circumference of the earth is around 25,000 miles. God says no one's measured that. You haven't measured that. You can't measure my earth. You can't search out the heavens. You're not supposed to be up there anyway. Okay. The breadth, when it talks about breadth in Scripture, it's talking about measuring. Let's see. Let's go to Ezekiel 40. Behold, a wall is on the outside of the house round about. And in the man's hand, a measuring reed of 6 cubits long, and the cubit and a hand breadth. So he measured the breadth of the building, 1 reed, and the height in 1 reed. Okay? So measuring the breadth of building, of a building. Let's see. All right. Where's God at in relation to earth? Is he, if they can go these millions and billions of miles away with all these probes, somehow they never run into God. They never run into to heaven, the most high, you know, the third heaven. They never run into him. Oh, that's weird. You know, because they want you to believe he's not up there. That's the whole point. All right? Isaiah 40:22, it is he, Lord God, that sitteth upon the circle of the earth. Walk outside right now. Walk outside and just look up and just sit there. Listen to them crickets, you know. Look at them stars. Just sit there and look. And just think. God is up there. His throne is up there. His throne. It is he that sitteth upon the circle of the earth, and the inhabitants thereof are as grasshoppers, that stretcheth out the heavens as a curtain, and spreadeth them out as a tent to dwell in. Isaiah 13:13, therefore I will shake the heavens, and the earth shall remove out of her place. The earth has a place, and it can be removed out of it. In the wrath of the Lord of hosts, this is the day of the Lord. This is in the future. In the day of his fierce anger. All right. This is amazing. This is awesome. Psalm 93:1-2, the Lord reigneth, he is clothed with majesty. The Lord is clothed with strength, wherewith he hath girded himself. He girded himself with that. The world also is established, and cannot be moved. Thy throne is established of old, thou art from everlasting. Psalm 104:5, who laid the foundations of the earth, that it should not be removed forever? Isaiah 45:18, for thus saith the Lord that created the heavens, God himself that formed the earth and made it, he hath established it, he created it not in vain, he formed it to be inhabited. I am the Lord and there is none else. by all these planets. They can't find life on them because they're stars. They're wandering stars. Right now, you can look out my backyard and see a bright star, brighter than most around it, that they say, I believe it's Mars. That it's a terrestrial, terra, meaning Earth-like, you know, substance, Earth. They sent a rover, Curiosity rover, to it. There's another one, I think it's Endurance or something like that. And most people don't even know this stuff. They call me an idiot. They don't even know what they believe, guys. Let's search these things out. Prove all things. Hold fast that which is good, okay? When you have the lens of, God is looking down on earth. He sees everything. His Spirit is ministering the gospel of grace today on earth, all right? Earth is dry land in the scripture. Earth is dry land, all right? We used to call it that. You know, we dig up the earth. We used to call it that. We don't call it that no more. We call it dirt or something like that, you know? Amen, Laura. Hey, I learned it probably two, 3 years ago. I did a lot of research. I've done PowerPoints. I've got a massive book folder full of information that I've dug into and studied this stuff. To declare God's righteousness is the gospel of grace. Declaring His glory, according to Psalm 19, everyone sees His glory in creation. Everyone does. Everyone. But they suppress, they hold the truth in unrighteousness. Okay. Man. Let me read this real quick, guys. Sorry. How about whenever the Lord says the face of the earth? A lot of people say that's not face, that's supposed to be surface. Okay, I work on airplanes. The propeller has a face. It's the flat part of the backside of the prop. The face. It's called the face. It's not called the surface. It's called the face. That's in Genesis 1:29, Numbers 22, Genesis 7. It's all over. Let's see. I talk about the ends of the earth all the time. Oh, you can't hear me? Uh-oh. Can you hear me now? Is it still working? You guys hear me? Okay. Awesome. Thank you, Lisa. I don't have any luck with Facebook Live audio. Yeah, Laura, sometimes you got to click off and click back on. I have a real hard time with that. All right. Isaiah 44:24. Thus saith the Lord, thy Redeemer, and he that formed thee from the womb. I am the Lord that maketh all things, that stretcheth forth the heavens alone. He ain't need no help. He don't need NASA to explain the heavens. This King James Bible will explain to you the heavens, man. That spreadeth abroad the earth by myself. Jeremiah 10, when he uttereth his voice, there is a multitude of waters in the heavens. I believe that's talking about his magnitude of his voice. He causeth the vapors to ascend from the ends of the earth. There's the ends of the earth again. Maketh the lightnings with rain and bringeth forth the wind out of his treasures. All right. Sun and moon move above our heads, not the earth. Psalm 19:4-6. Their line as creation has gone out throughout all the earth, and their words to the end of the world. Creation cries, proclaims God. Okay? That's what Psalm 19:1-6 pretty much is about. In them hath he set a tabernacle for the sun, which is as a bridegroom coming out of his chamber, and rejoiceth as a strong man to run a race. His going forth is from the end of the heaven, and his circuit circuit unto the ends of it. And there is nothing hid from the heat thereof. There's nothing hid from the heat thereof. Now look at this one verse. It was kind of interesting earlier. Son of righteousness. I saw this the other day. It still puzzles me. See what you guys think. Malachi 4:2. But unto you that fear my name shall the Son, S-U-N, capital, of righteousness, arise with healing in his wings. And ye shall go forth and grow up as calves of the stall. Seems like the Lord is making kind of a, I'm not sure. What do you guys think about that? That's kind of crazy to me. I never read that verse before until the other day. Son of righteousness, arise with healing in his wings. I think that was pretty cool. Almost like he's making a comparison with the Lord and the sun. I'm not sure about the moon, stars. Maybe the stars is the multitude of the angels. I'm not sure how that correlates. Is the sun the Lord Jesus Christ, the moon the Father, and the stars representing the Spirit of God because they're in multitude, they're everywhere? I'm not positive. I'm not sure about that. I thought it was just kind of neat how it says Son of Righteousness. Pretty cool. Alright, the same line of thought with the sun and moon move. The wind goeth towards the south, Ecclesiastes 1:6, and turneth about unto the north. It whirleth about continually, and the wind returneth again according to his circuits. So that's a direct path. The circuit is a path that the wind is taking. Saw it in this last verse right here we just went over in Psalm 19. That the sun is taking a circuit, a path, okay? Job 9:7, which commandeth the sun, and it riseth not, and sealeth up the stars. The sun is moving, all right? Joshua 10, man, Joshua's long day, guys. If you read books or commentaries about Joshua's long day, how the Lord stopped the sun and the moon in the sky, he said nothing about the earth stopping or stop moving, this and that. There's commentaries for days on this stuff. Just simply believe the words of God as it is written. Man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceedeth out of the mouth of God. You know, Matthew 4:4, I believe. So Joshua 10, this is a miracle that happened in the book of Joshua in the Old Testament. Whenever, and this is literal stuff. This has really happened, guys. This is really real history. Joshua was going on during a battle. He needed more light, more daytime, more light to fight. He asked the Lord to stop, to give him more light. And then spake Joshua to the Lord in the day when the Lord delivered up the Amorites before the children of Israel. He said in the sight of Israel, Sun, stand thou still upon Gibeon, and thou, moon, in the valley of Ahalon. Okay? Nothing about the earth moving. If you just picture that in your mind, sun and the moon stopped. How does that work with the earth moving still? It doesn't work. It doesn't work. I love this book. To tell something to stop, it by default had to be moving first, right? Alright. It recounts this in Habakkuk, however you want to say it, 3:11. The sun and the moon stood still in their habitation. That's that tabernacle he was talking about. At the light of thine arrows they went, and at the shining of thy glittering spear. He's talking about the battle right there. Light of thine arrows and spear. He's talking about the battle. Alright, so 2 Kings 20. I know it's a lot, but I love this stuff, man. The Lord stops the sun from moving. Not the earth, the sun. The sun and the moon move above us. The stars rotate. Rotates, it compasses the north star, and it rotates. That's the firmament. Hezekiah said unto Isaiah, what shall be the sign of the Lord will heal me, that the Lord will heal me? that I shall go up in the house of the Lord the third day. Third day, that's kind of weird. Never saw that. Isaiah said, this sign shalt thou have of the Lord, and the Lord will do the thing which he hath spoken. Shall the shadow go forward 10 degrees? Talking about the sundial, okay? Old school sundial. Shall the shadow go forth 10 degrees or go back 10 degrees? Hezekiah answered, it is a light thing for, I love this stuff right here. It is a light thing for the shadow to go down 10 degrees. Nay, but let the shadow return backward 10 degrees. Isaiah the prophet cried unto the Lord. He brought the shadow 10 degrees backward, by which it had gone down dial of Ahaz. The sun, imagine the sun sitting there, noonday, let's just say noonday. Imagine the sun going back 10 degrees. Okay? The sun moves. This is scary in Jeremiah 8. When I first read this, man, this freaked me out. At that time, Jeremiah 8, 1 through 3. At that time, saith the Lord, they shall bring out the bones of the kings of Judah. Whew. The bones of his princes, the bones of the priests, bones of the prophets, the bones of the inhabitants of Jerusalem, out of their graves. And they shall spread them out before the sun and the moon and all the hosts of heaven, whom they have loved, whom they have loved, whom they have served, whom and after whom they have walked, whom they have sought and worshipped. They shall not be gathered nor be buried. They shall be for dung upon the face of the earth, and death shall be chosen rather than life. By all the residue of them that remain of this evil family, which remain in all the places whither I have driven them, saith the Lord of hosts. They don't want to worship God, but sinfully worship creation, not the Creator. That is Romans chapter 1. They worship the creature more than the Creator, who is blessed forever. Amen. Here's some facts. I made some bulletin points of my study years ago. I have a whole folder full of stuff. I've downloaded several teachings, even facts of NASA and SpaceX that they completely contradict themselves. If you want to go on my YouTube channel, The Backyard Gospel Project. Let me see if I have any playlists I can share with you guys. Truth is so important today, it's unbelievable. My playlist, I have... I'm not sure if these are... private or not. I don't think they are. So I have one... Balls Out Physics with Brian Mullen. You look at that. That is an amazing teaching from a engineer about all the things I'm telling you about. Okay? All the things I'm telling you about. So, I don't have an engineering degree. He does. He goes through the math and science of the heliocentric type model and shows you they contradict themselves throughout. Let's see. I've got several things. Yeah, it's a lie, Laura, but the thing is we can sit confident and rest in God's word being so true, it's unbelievable. So that's the thing. Most people don't want to understand or learn this stuff, and they shy away from it because they're so afraid that the world they live in is a lie and God is true. If so, they have to seek him. Seek the book. The Lord tells Israel, seek out of the book of the Lord and read. Okay? That's what I've been doing. I've been reading Genesis and I'm in Exodus right now. It's a blessing to read through the scriptures. You get a picture of everything. I understand now from Genesis 22 why the Lord wanted Isaac to go up on the hill with Abraham. I understand it now. Go to Hebrews 11. It explains it to you. God is not going to leave you blind. He's not going to leave you sitting there wondering. You keep searching for it. Keep searching. Give him the benefit of the doubt, guys. Benefit of the doubt. when you read something in Scripture that don't seem to fit NASA's model and stuff like that, hey, man, I had a choice to make. Believe God or believe man. I'm telling you right now. When I searched these things, I mean, I was looking at this one with the asteroid that NASA was gonna put a probe on an asteroid, allegedly, to bring back a sample, apparently. The asteroid's called Bennu. Bennu means an ancient Egyptian deity linked with the sun, creation, and rebirth. Why wouldn't they call it that? You know what I'm saying? If Psalm 19 is true, the heavens declare the glory of God, and the firmament showeth his handiwork, of course they're going to call it Bennu. It's ridiculous. The moon and sun appear to be the same size by the naked eye, and they appear close to us. It's because they are. That's how God made it. He made it simple for us to understand. If the moon's a light, you can't land on a light. You say, what are you talking about? Have you ever... just think of this. Let's say the moon is 100 lumens from where we're sitting. Okay? 100 lumens. It's pretty bright at night a lot of times. Now, travel 140,000 miles closer to it. You wouldn't even be able to see. It'd be so bright. However, the math, I don't know how to do the math of that. I saw one guy how he did the math and calculated it. It was unbelievable how bright the moon would be if it was true that you can go to it 140,000 miles away. Super bright. How about gravity? Gravity is weight. Then they changed the definition in textbooks recently. Gravity is weight. So that is density and buoyancy. Look up Operation Dominic, Operation Fishbowl, Operation Paperclip. Do you know how fast that the science says the sun is moving through the universe? As far as we're traveling with it, we're spinning around the sun. But the sun is going, but we see the same stars every. The same time of year, we see the exact same stars, the exact same spot. The sun is supposedly going at 515,000 miles an hour. The Earth is rotating upon its axis at the equator, allegedly 1,000 miles an hour. 1,000 miles an hour. And the angle of the Earth's axis, they say that they have figured out the angle of the Earth's axis, 23.5 degrees. Formula for the Earth's curvature is eight inches per mile squared. I've done the formula for certain things I've looked through with my camera. I got a P900 camera. I can zoom in from Tybee Island, Georgia to Hilton Head, Georgia, from the pier. I've done the formula. We shouldn't be able to see the whole buildings and stuff, according to their math science. Everything has a purpose in creation. God didn't create it in vain. He created it to be inhabited, the earth to be inhabited. When in the first verse of the scripture, God created, in the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. That's heaven and the earth. Heaven is celestial, earth is terrestrial. They're both literal places. One is heavenly, the other is terrestrial. Terra means earth, okay? So he separates those two. Let's say, so right now we understand that the sun, moon, and stars are above us in the heavens, right? Well, if you could, supposedly they can, whatever, land on Mars. And you turn around and you look at the earth. Now the earth is in the heavens. That is completely contrary to the creator of the universe, whatever you want to call it, the creator of the creation. Okay? Why do we call it sea level? Because the sea is level. It's not a round, stuck, this and that. How do we get air pressure if we don't have a container to contain the pressure? If you read the account in Genesis 1 of creation, earth was here before the sun. Look up Antarctic Treaty System. Train tracks and bridges do not account for the alleged curvature of the earth. We went to Daytona International Speedway in Florida. Okay. Sitting there doing a tour. And a guy, this is like a, let me look up how big the Daytona Speedway is. Size or whatever. Alright, so Daytona International Speedway. 2.5 mile tri-oval, okay? So the guy that was doing the tour said that the speedway was so big they had to account for the curvature of the earth in order to build it. It's only 2.5 miles across, tri-oval. 2.5 miles. Your eye can see, I think it's 3 miles, 4 miles, I can't remember how far your eye can see straight and level on the ocean, the sea. You're on the bank of the sea, you look out, you can see for miles. And you can't, and you don't see any curvature. Even whenever you see the boats go away from you, they say, well, Bill Nye the Science Guy when I was a kid told me this because the boats are going over the curve. Well, that P900 camera, I can zoom right in that bad boy and bring it back up. Explain that one. Bill Nye the Science Guy. So, clouds can be seen behind the sun in several videos and pictures. And behind the moon. I've actually witnessed that myself through my camera. Sun can have localized hotspots in a lot of videos and pictures we see. All you gotta do is search for these high-altitude balloons that go up that don't have a fisheye lens. You'll see the more accurate account of the Earth, what it looks like. Why do they lie? I told you earlier, to hide the glory of God in creation. It's perpetuated to make you feel lonely, and it's insignificant in the vastness of space. And Jesus Christ is not close to you in their model. A lot of people say about Isaiah 40:22 about the circle of the earth. Well, see, that's a ball right there. Isaiah, and by inspiration of God, did not use the Hebrew word ball. I don't do Hebrew and Greek. I never do Hebrew and Greek. This is for my first part of the studies of this thing. So don't hold me to this. But it is a truth that they showed. The Hebrew word is not ball in 40:22 of Isaiah. It is for circle. Circle is a 2D object. God's looking down. He sees a circle. The whole earth, he sees a circle. So looking down, God can see the whole earth at one time from his throne. How does that work on a sphere? Tired of NASA's lies. I hope you guys are too by now. It's all perpetuated by the controlled media. There's like 5 or 6 companies that own everything that you see, hear, whatever. Controlled media makes these things possible. If you control the media, you control the narrative. Most people are watching the debate tonight. If you control the media, you can control the narrative. All right. Let's look at some stuff. Let's look at NASA's documents and government documents I have here listed from several sources that have grabbed these off of the actual website, CIA website. These are all declassified documents that from the Freedom of Information Act. Describing the Earth and what their findings are. Here's a list of it, guys. You want to know why these things are important? Well, it's important for them to spend billions of dollars on it to study the Earth and the heavens. All right, I even printed out a few of them just to make sure people didn't think I was lying to them. Russia, 1948. This is CIA.gov. Shape of the Earth unknown. This is that's a quote from the actual document, Russia, 1948. Russia light study, brightness of the firmament, and that's CIA.gov. Army, let's see, ARL.army.mil, propagation of electromagnetic fields over flat earth. I didn't say that, they said it, okay? Page 9 of this document, army.mil, based upon the signal having a single bounce on a flat earth. Trajectory of spinning projectiles in page 1 of this army document. These equations assume a flat earth. Page 2 of this army report. This is a report. Equations assume flat earth. This is quotations from it. I've printed out several of these. Same thing with page 216 of this on the Navy, Navy.mil. Let's go over to NASA one. I'm not going to go through all these things. My phone's about to die anyway. NASA.gov. Page 2, NASA.gov on this document. Now, I have the document numbers right here. I'm not just saying this is from a NASA document somewhere. You know, the numbers are right there. So let's keep going. In this paper, this is page 2, the rigid body equations of motion over a flat, non-rotating Earth are developed. That's NASA. Okay, here's a pretty tricky one on this one. On page 1 of this document, it does mention a spherical rotating Earth, but then states these schemes based on a spherical rotating Earth are difficult to prove and not suggested to be used as a basis for an online real-time guidance law. Lastly, the equations of motion for a zeroth order problem of flight in a vacuum over a flat earth are represented. So, not making this stuff up. Alright. Believe what you want, I don't care. Me and my family believe God. Yeah, people call us stupid. That's fine. God calls you ignorant. And he laughs at it. Because his word is available, and his ministers are ministering the gospel of grace and biblical creation. You can believe all this stuff if you want to. Let God be true and every man lie. So I got to get off here. My phone's about to die. Thank you, Laura. I appreciate you guys joining me. Yeah, we've all believed lies. That's the thing where it's the whole point of it is I believe the lie also. I'm not out of the loop with this stuff. I believe the lies also, along with everybody. But God that commanded the light to shine out of darkness has shined in our hearts. Okay, give us knowledge of the Son of God, all right? I pray that your eyes of your understanding will be enlightened. To the hope of his calling, and also to the wonderful things of his word in the King James Bible. Thy word is true from the beginning, and every one of thy righteous judgments endureth forever. I love that quote. Brother Paul Lucas uses that quote a lot. So I got to get off here, guys. I appreciate you guys joining me. If you're a member of the body of Christ, preach the word. It's such a blessing to understand the scriptures rightly divided. I didn't grow up none of this stuff. Amazing thing what God has done, giving us his word, not leaving us to ourselves like the heliocentric model wants us to believe. He is close. He is close to us. And if you're a believer that in the gospel of grace, he died for your sins, was buried and rose again, you're believing that, trusting that alone for salvation. He's so close to you that his spirit lives in you. By his word, his spirit, he can teach you all of his wisdom and understanding and knowledge because of his grace, because of his mercy. The wonderful things that he has for us to learn, especially in the ages to come, it's going to be overwhelming, I believe. That's why we need a glorified body to understand it and believe and understand it and to be able to receive it. You know, that's amazing to me. The Lord says, if I told you, what does he say to Nicodemus? If I told you earthly things, you believe not. How can I tell you spiritual things? That's how a lot of people are today. All they see is the earthly. Let us get to the spiritual, and walk by faith, not by sight. I'm not talking about don't use your senses God gave you. Don't use your senses to see his creation. Walking by faith in his word, as far as the gospel of grace, the hope of glory, the salvation is by faith alone, and the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ. It's awesome. So if you're religious, if you're in church, not understanding anything, not knowing if you're saved, you're saved by trusting gospel of grace. You have assurance by reading the scriptures, Romans through Philemon, and comparing that with what you're being taught, and you'll see the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Be blessed, guys. Thank you so much for joining me. Share this thing. It's probably super long, but when I get to talk about God's word, I cannot shut up. He's my heavenly Father, and I'm telling you, he does not want us to be in darkness. He has translated us to the kingdom of his dear Son, out of darkness into the light. We're children of light, walking the day, okay? Thank you, guys. What a blessing. Be blessed. Have a wonderful night.